Explain the process of dual converter without circulating current. After studying the principle of dual converter, here we'll discuss its modes. There are two modes in a dual converter. One with circulating current and the other without the circulating current. Here we'll study the second mode only. In a dual converter without any circulating current, have only one converter in the operation at a time and it carries the entire load within it only. Here the mode of dual converter is a part of practical dual converter actually. So in a practical dual converter, when both the positive and negative converters are working together at different firing angles, then it is noted that their average output is same, but its instantaneous voltage is different and out of phase also. Thus, due to these differences, a large circulating current flows through the converters when they are connected with each other. But this current can be ignored if we trigger the converter suitably. Coming to the brief discussion of our main topic, that is dual converter without circulating current. In a dual converter without circulating current operating mode, the flow of circulating current is completely inhibited through automatic control of the firing pulses, so that only that converter which carries the load current is in conduction, and the other converter is temporarily blocked. Since only one conductor operates at a time and the other is in blocking state, no reactor is required between the converters. There are two types of operations taking place here, namely inversion and rectification. For the inversion operation, converter 1 is first blocked by removing its firing pulses and load current is reduced to zero, and converter 2 is made to conduct by applying the firing pulses to it. The current in converter 2 would now build up through the load in the reverse direction. So as long as converter 2 is in operation, converter 1 is in the blocking state since the firing pulses are withdrawn from it. And similarly, in rectification mode, converter 1 will supply the load current, while pulses to second converter are blocked, and the pulses to converter 2 are applied after a delay time of 10 to 20 ms. This delay time ensures reliable communication of thyristors in converter 1. If the converter 2 is triggered before the converter 1 has been completely turned off, a large circulating current will flow between the two converters. Thus, from the above discussion, it becomes clear that such a mode of operation requires sophisticated control system, so that automatic blocks and unblocks the individual converters in accordance with the direction of load current suitably with a safety interval. Now let's summarize the process of dual converter without circulating current.